With the first pick in the 2023 NBA draft, the San Antonio Spurs select Victor Wembanyama.
You got teammates like these, it's kind of hard. It's hard to come by. This is why I want to be. I want to figure it out. Figure it out over here.
You know, we just got to lock in and just have some fun.
Good evening, everyone, from San Antonio. Welcome to the NBA preseason.
Oh, Barlow finds Champagnie.
So him. Wembanyama!
I mean, it's all the talk, so we're going back to tonight's big game. Spurs fans were all ready for tip-off. At the Frost Bank Center, the silver and black taking on the Dallas Mavericks.
Feeling lucky as always, but also focused, locked in, you know. And yeah, we know what we gotta do. It's gotta start with the good way to start is with a win. Maybe like a month ago, I thought that some preseason games would prepare me for that moment, and that it would be like just another game maybe, but it feels totally different.
Seems like there's more cameras around for this one than the ones in the past.
But I wonder why. Yeah, there definitely is more attention, more cameras, media and everything, but you know, we've been able to stay focused on, you know, what matters most, and just continue to work on us.
I think every year, every opening night is pretty big. You know, obviously it's going to be a lot more eyes, a lot more attention, but every opening night is always super exciting.
We welcome you to NBA Wednesday, presented by State Farm. Tonight in San Antonio, Texas, getting ready for the Spurs and the Mavericks.
It's tip-off time in San Antonio.
There it is, the first points in the career of Victor Wembanyama.
It's the team that got seven former NBA guys on that roster, and he was able to produce.
And produces again right there on a three, so two field goals for Wembanyama. Branham off and running, lays it in, plus the foul.
That back door, his ability to finish, the paint pulls in. He's going to get open shots.
Cassie wide open center of the paint.
He can have a quiet
Wembanyama
night.
Wembanyama connects on a three. Rebound Jones. Chance for San Antonio. Wemby the deep catch, the turn, and the flush. Plus the foul.
That's surreal for a moment. I just feel very lucky to be here. Lots of emotions, of course, but, you know, would have been perfect with a win.
How did you think Victor responded to spending the night in foul trouble?
I think it was great. One of the toughest things for a player is you get into foul trouble and you never get in a rhythm and you're in and out of the game and that sort of thing. So I thought his maturity showed, even at a young age, where he came in with the last, I think, 7 minutes, where a lot of guys would have been totally out of it by then.
He helped us out in the fourth quarter. We know what Victor's going to do. You know, he made some timely shots, some big possessions, and he's not going to be in foul trouble every game. So I'm expecting a great game from him coming out against Houston.
You think Victor got some rookie calls the other night, and what can he do to adjust to that?
I don't want to say rookie calls. You know, it's just a lot of ticky-tack fouls, I feel like. Things that he definitely will learn from. I mean, Vic's a smart player. You know, he'll make adjustments, and he'll be fine.
Best thing about the NBA is there's always one the next night. There's always another one. We got 81 more of these things at least. So he's very mature for his age, and he'll be okay. All I can do is just give him confidence and keep doing his thing.
Gives it up to Vassell.
There is again. The
lob. Hey! It's a pass out front, almost intercepted, but Jones got it back. Trey off to the left wing. Malaki Branham for three. Buckeye from Trey Jones. 5 points for Malaki Branham, and the Spurs lead by five. Looking down low on the block, it is Wembanyama against Jabari Smith. Spins him inside, reverse slam dunk for Victor Wembanyama.
Rockets, advantage, Smith.
Oh my! Blocked again by Wemby. Get it out of here. 14 to shoot. Down to Wembanyama at the baseline. Drives it inside. Off the glass. Shot is good for Victor Wembanyama. We are tied at 111.
Tied for the 10th time. Shot clock turned off. 7 on the clock. Smith. No. Wembanyama tied up. Jump ball. 1.9 on the clock. Wemby. Sohan. And that will send it to overtime.
Inbounds pass will come from Trey Jones at the baseline. To Wembanyama. Catch and shoot baseline. Jumper is good for Victor Wembanyama.
8 seconds to go. Ahead. Victor with 4. Sohan again. Johnson. Oh, my goodness. That will take care of business. 126-122. Spurs win in overtime.
Coming back in the locker room, you know, Pop acknowledged that it was my first ever, you know, NBA win, and it just made me proud, you know, for a moment, proud of myself. And we got a whole lot more to come and a whole lot more tough games to come, so focus on the next one, but I'm still very proud.
I mean, me and him were talking the whole time. We both said we didn't want to lose this game, and we knew that we were both going to have to try and take over at some point, and I feel like that's what we did, you know, giving it to him and him, you know, forcing us to go into overtime.
He wants the ball at the end of the games. He wants those big shots, and he's best in those moments, and we saw it tonight. You know, having him have the ball in his hand at the end of the games and, you know, making those big plays, it just shows, you know, the winner he is.
Five games into the season, how are you feeling and shaping up so far?
I think it's been great. You know, the guys are fighting. Everybody's working to get better. We push each other. So I feel like that's the most important part. The competitiveness, and everybody got it, and everybody wants to win. And I feel like we're building a great culture. I'm being in the gym, you know, putting extra work in, you know, working on my mental. Just to, you know, be ready, 82 games, long season. You can't put your head down ever in the NBA, you know, no matter what you're going through. So, you know, just staying high spirits. You know, teammates got my back. We're really good friends with everybody. So, you know, just staying positive, staying ready, and just working on my game as much as possible.
Bye, Sandro.
The young Spurs pulled off an early season favorite for comeback of the year the other night. Tonight, though, the task gets a little bit tougher. He tried to sidestep Wembanyama. Trey Jones pushing back to Victor. Look out! Lift off and detonation for Wembanyama.
And Malachi tries to get back to Grayson Allen.
Victor Wembanyama, nothing but the bottom on that three-pointer out. It's a switch with Grayson Allen.
I'll throw it up to him.
Malachi back to Victor for 2 more.
Make somebody else make a play. Make him make an extra pass.
How about that spin move by Victor? And underneath, Drew Eubanks lays it up and in.
In the fourth quarter, in the NBA, you just have to make big plays. You're not going to have many chances if you don't try to kill your opponent right away.
Wembanyama met outside by Eubanks. Victor, pull up three. Got it! Victor Wembanyama hits the strings, and the Spurs have rattled off 10 unanswered.
That, my friend, is superstar material. Milk this thing all the way down. You should not be in a hurry.
Victor pulls up at the elbow, and Victor Wembanyama, 38 points with 10 rebounds tonight. And the San Antonio Spurs will sweep the Suns here in the Valley of the Sun.
And today might have been in this way, and tomorrow it will be someone else, you know. It's how great teams work, you know. We want to be great, we need to play with everyone.
He's got confidence in himself. And, you know, he made some plays that were, you know, unbelievable.
He's his own player person. He's going to create his own lane. He's much different than anybody who's ever played. You can try to compare, but he's going to carve out his own lane.
I assume you don't have a diagnosis on Vassell yet.
I'd imagine we'll lose him for a little while.
Does that mean more opportunity for Branham, you think?
Well, somebody else has to play.
6'4 guard from Ohio State, number 22, Malachi Branham.
Branham looking for a crease.
so good in that mid-range, and he is playing oozing with confidence.
Yes, he is. Yeah, he started off hot in the second half, and on this side of the floor.
Branham with a backdoor cut, lays it up and in. Branham, a little short, got his own.
How y'all doing? Next man up. You know, it's not my first time starting. I started a lot of games last year, so, you know, just being ready.
He did a good job. He came in and guarded pretty well. You know, made a few shots. He filled in nicely.
What's your confidence level like now compared to this time last year?
I know what to expect. I know how to, you know, read the defenses. And the game has slowed down for me. You know, last year, you know, it was a lot of things. I sped up. So me just being at my own pace, me knowing my spots on the court, just stuff like that. So, yeah.
Why is this the best city in the world?
I mean, do you see it? Nah, it's just the culture, the diversity, the energy around it. And everybody wants to come here. I can't really explain it, but everybody wants to be here. It's just the best. Coming here with an NBA team it's a different feeling. Obviously, it's a business trip, but you get to just kind of chill.
Look out, Champagnie! Champagnie, a pull-up.
I think it's just the best thing you can do is just like come back home and experience family, friends, and you know, old stomping grounds, and with people, you know, with new people, new friends, stuff like that. So it's pretty cool.
But they're paying tribute to Julian Champagnie. Champagnie, now a member of the San Antonio Spurs.
Playing with St. John's in there, a bunch of games, and then now being back and, you know, playing with the NBA team.
Yeah.
Can't beat that.
Can't beat that.
Can't beat that. That's every New York kid's dream. Every New York kid's dream.
With a game under their belt already, the Austin Spurs host the Osceola Magic for their home opener of Showcase Cup play. McCoy finds Barlow rolling to the basket, and nice reverse to use the rim for protection.
Orlando pretty much leading the way for the most of it.
Barlow will give the Spurs the lead.
For Jermaine Samuels Jr. Barlow, and a new career high for Dom.
What have you done to improve your game over the offseason coming into this season?
Understanding the body of work that's required to play in the NBA. I've been training this whole time to, you know, come here and get minutes in San Antonio. So even if I'm in Austin, that work doesn't stop. During the offseason, my day-to-day schedule, I was just every day, consistency. In the morning, at night, I was getting in work no matter where I was. Seeing something twice is a lot easier than seeing it the first time. You know, my confidence level just kind of went up during the season, and that's what's been able to help me in the start.
Let's take a wild stab, but will you start Malaki in place of Devin tonight?
No.
Ah, who's it going to be?
You sound excited.
I'm so excited.
Julian.
Julian. What did you like about what Julian did last game?
He made a couple buckets later in the game. You know, when you haven't played much and you're young and you come off the bench, you don't want to make a mistake. You're a little hesitant, probably, a little too careful, but he came more at ease as the game went along. Did a good job.
This starts a four-game homestand. Champagnie lines up and knocks it down and cuts after. Beautiful feed inside from Champagnie, and the easy dunk at 7-0.
That's just a great cut, though, you know?
Murray, here comes a double team. Wembanyama pokes it away. Champagnie had a chance for a lob. There it is, and an easy finish. McGee gets out on the perimeter. Wembanyama hits a three. Wembanyama has some time, throws it ahead. Branham inside. Alley-oop. Oh, he puts it in! Mamukelashvili just threw it up with the basket at the buzzer. This is Branham, knocks down the shot.
The first thing Pop said, coming into the locker room, he acknowledged our effort.
Really pleased with their, you know, their effort. You know, in a situation where we can't make as many youthful mistakes as we make. You know, we just played an experienced all-star, a couple all-star guys, and it showed. They're all learning, and it's frustrating as hell to lose. But you got to put it in perspective and understand what's going on.
I mean, there's sacrifices to do, you know. Of course, it's hard to be patient sometimes, as always. I know that the end of the season would not look like the beginning of the season. We got a good way to go, you know, progression.
Oh, my
Zach Collins ones, man.
What's up?
Zach Collins ones. Just so y'all know. ZC ones.
Penny connect, connect. Mamu all over the glass.
So Mamu's active right now.
You know, through no fault of his own, obviously he kind of fell out of the lineup and he stayed ready and he came in and he was Mamu, so.
You know, I love the way he plays. He hasn't gotten many minutes, but he moves as well as anybody on our team.
A couple times tonight, our offense, you know, we couldn't execute the play broke and we just swung it to him and he attacked the rim and got some free throws, got some reaching fouls, put pressure on defense. It was great.
And it feels great. We didn't have a lot of playing time in the beginning. You know, I've been through it for the past 2 years with Milwaukee, so throughout the league, you gotta stay ready. You gotta always work on yourself when the lights are off, and you know, stay positive no matter what. Attitude never changed, and it's all about attitude. So, you know, I was trying to be a great teammate and contribute that way, but I knew once I would get my chance, I'll go there and give my 110%, and you know, that helped me, like the coaching staff. Keeping me ready, play groups keeping me ready, performance styles keeping me ready. That all just paid the price and it was great.
It does feel good though to finally get in there and do a little something though, right?
Yep. It does. It feels great, man. It feels great.
Mr. Wembanyama, the 19-year-old phenom doing some things tonight, out in transition. Anytime he gets a face-up, boy, that jumper starting to take shape.
And now you look at his patience, a great read. Just throw it up anywhere, he'll get it. Take your time, big fella. You'll get every shot.
Well, they talk about how he just, amongst his teammates, he carries himself and wants to carry himself and be looked at as just one of the guys. And that's not easy for a 19-year-old with all these expectations, with the spotlight, being the face of the franchise. And you're younger than everybody else. Guys have played their NBA dues as Branham knocks the...